He writes, I want to invest some money for regular income in debt funds. I chose 8 debt funds based on ratings and returns and invested in them. Mm-hmm. 45 days on, 4 of them have given negative returns. 2 are dynamic bond funds, 1 gilt fund and 1 income fund. What should I do now?
If you are actually, money for periodic income and regular income without significant downside, because dynamic bond fund and gilt fund, whenever the outlook changes, they might get a hit.
Okay.
Not that, it's unusual. If interest rates go up, mutual funds, the debt funds actually go down in value because the older, that's the mechanism. Old bonds held by a fund, which will be yielding lower return, gets priced down. So from that standpoint, if 45 days, if you want regular income, get conservative. Get conservative with maybe a short-term debt fund. That will insulate you from any of these interim declines, because particularly the gilt fund and the dynamic bond fund, over a long period of time, they will give superior return, but they will come, their return will have the ups and downs. So the income fund, the dynamic bond fund, gilt funds are not suited for consistent return. If you're looking for consistent return month after month, day after day, from, you should consider a liquid fund or an ultra short-term bond fund and short-term bond fund, nothing else.
So when should one exit from them?
But depends, looking at return on a 45-day basis from this debt fund, he could be in for a surprise, because if interest rates go up, these funds can actually take a hit. But debt funds do take a hit, but the magnitude of hit, the negative return will be of a very insignificant kind.
Okay.
1%, 2%. It doesn't happen like equity that your investment value is down 15%. Mm. So look at this time frame. If you want regular income, move to short-term debt fund. If this is a long-term fixed income investment, because you are a risk-averse investor, maybe you should consider staying in some of the dynamic bond fund. Definitely not in the gilt fund, because gilt funds, they reflect the change in the outlook of interest rates immediately. Okay. They turn out to be far more volatile, okay, simply because they're more liquid.